بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. The undesirable act of the prayers. Tonight, inshallah, we'll talk about one more thing, which is praying on what we call it in Arabic, kawr al-imama, kawr al-imama. Now, you can see in the winter, many people wearing hats, the winter hats, and some of it's covering the entire forehead. They need it because of the cold weather. Some of us, by nature, they are wearing imama. Maybe not here, but somewhere else. If you see in Afghanistan and Pakistan, and they have big ones. In Sudan, they have a huge one. In also North Africa, especially the religious people, they wear what we call it imama. And some people, they wear what we don't call it imama, but we call it hat, like this one. And some of it covering the head, and some of it covering the forehead. Yani for me, I like to do it this way. Some people, they do it this way, but I like to cover part of my, because I'm bald, but I would like to cover part of my my forehead as well. All of this, regardless if it's a hat, winter hat, or a regular one, or a imama with different circles, ties. If it's all of this is covering your head, just the head, not the forehead, then there is no problem at all. As far as your forehead is uncovered, then your sujood is completely perfect according to all of the school of practice. If what you are wearing in your head, a hat or imama, imama with one layer, imama with more than one layer, like the Sudani one, like 20 layers, Afghani one, Irani one, they have big, many layers, covering your forehead, then we'll see what is the Islamic ruling about it. According to the vast majority of scholars, Hanafi and Maliki and Hanbali, in one opinion, they said it's undesirable. Undesirable means makruh, against the preference, to pray and to make your sujood touching the ground on the top of your imama, not the forehead. It's undesirable. It's not haram, but it's undesirable, against the preference, to make your sujood in your hat, on your hat, on your imama, whatever you are wearing, and not to touch the ground with your forehead. Direct contact between your forehead and the ground. It's undesirable. And when we say undesirable, again, the prayers are acceptable, are valid, but it's against the preference. The preference is what? To touch your sujood point with a naked forehead, uncovered forehead. This opinion versus another opinion, which is Shafi'i and Zahiri and Zaydi, and also a report in Al-Hanbali, they said uncovering your forehead means moving the imama up to cover your head only, not the forehead or hat or whatever you are wearing. It's a must. And if you did your sujood on the ground with your hat, with your imama, then your prayers are invalid, are not acceptable. We'll see the evidence of each opinion. The first group, which is Hanafi and Maliki, and Hanbali in one opinion. They said, there is a hadith in al-Bukhari, hadith sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim, from Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu wa ardah. He said, he was describing their prayer with the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, we used to pray at the time of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam in a hot weather. You know that over there, touching the ground when the hot weather, if it's 50 or 55, it's burning. And they didn't have, in the beginning of the Islam, they didn't have rugs on the ground. They used to pray on the sand or rugs. We used to do, he said, we used to do our sujood in very hot weather. If someone of us could not stand the heat of the ground, we grab part of our clothes, part of our clothes, and keep it between us, between our forehead and the ground. Then he's using something similar to that. It's not the imamah, but he's grabbing something from his from his clothes, regardless if it's a mantle or a qamis or anything that he's wearing. He grabbed some of it and keep it on the ground in front of him while he was making his sujood. Then the scholar, they said, this is an evidence that you can use extra clothes to protect yourself, to protect your forehead from the ground, even if it's part of what you are wearing. And part of you are wearing is a hat. It's the hat that you are wearing. However, the Hanafi, they said, to do this and for your prayer to be acceptable, the cover of al-imamah, the tie, the circle that we do it, or the hat, it should be on the forehead, not the head itself. But if you are doing like this, and you are making the sujood on this imamah, not touching the ground with your forehead, just by your head with the imamah, then your prayers are invalid. For the imamah to be acceptable, even if it's against the preference, should cover your forehead, not the head, not only the head, head and the forehead. Why? Because if you did it just on your head, the sujood in your head, then you are missing one part. Umirtu an asjuda ala sab'ati, seven parts, your feet, your knees, your hands, and your forehead, seven of them. If you did it in your head, then you did not use your forehead. Your forehead, one of them. And also Maliki, they have some details. Because they know some people, they might use a big one, a big imamah, especially, it's still used until now in the south of Morocco and Sahara. And Mali and these countries, they use big ones. So they said the big ones is completely a shield between you and your head. So this is not acceptable. The acceptable one should be a soft one. One layer, they said maximum two layers. Other than that, if it's more than two layers, the ties around your head, if it's more than two layers, then your prayers also unacceptable.
Even if your forehead is open?
No, if your forehead is uncovered and you are using your you are not making your sujood in the imamah, then you are using your forehead. But the said in case that you are making sujood in the imamah, which is covering the forehead. By the way, other than the hadith of Sahih Muslim and al-Bukhari, which is a hadith of Anas, there is many a hadith talking about that either the Nabi did a sujood in his imamah, which is covering the forehead, or the Sahaba did it. After studying all of this hadith, none of them is authentic. But they can support each other, but none of them individually authentic hadith. But we have also in Hanafi another evidence for the, to reply to the claim of the Shafi'i that the prayer on the hat is not acceptable. They said, what is the difference? Why you are not allowing the prayer? They said, to apply your forehead on the sujood spot. They said, you agree with us that we can pray on the rug. In this case, we don't touch, we don't apply our forehead on the ground. We do it, I do it in the prayer rug, right? And you do it in the prayer rugs here. But in reality, regardless, we don't do it in the ground anymore. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam also did his prayer in the presence of the Sahaba on a rug. This means you don't apply your forehead on the ground. For if you don't, if you are not obligated or you are not required to apply your forehead on the ground, 100% on the ground, then it doesn't matter if you are having imama or you don't have imama, because it will be like a rug, extra garment that you are using. Also, another analysis we have it in Hanafi to support our opinion. They said forehead, it's mentioned in the hadith of the seven parts, right? What other parts?
Feet.
Huh? Feet.
Knees.
And hands. Can we cover our knees? This, the way it should be. Then if it's covering the knees is allowed, then covering the forehead is allowed. What is the difference between forehead and the knees? Can we cover our feet? We wear socks. We wear khuf. Then we don't apply it completely naked. But he said, what is the difference between the knees and the forehead? Why we are making distinction between this one it should be uncovered, this one it should be covered. If you said, oh, for the knees because it's part of the awrah, then we say, what about the feet? The feet are not part of the awrah. Then the second opinion, which is Shafi'i and Zahiri and Zaydi and one report in Hanbali, they said, no, you for your prayers to be accepted, you have to uncover your forehead. And if you used anything to cover it, hat or imama or anything, and you did the sujood on this, your prayers are invalid. And they use some evidence. One of them that Sayyiduna Khabbab said, we came to Nabi alayhi salallahu alayhi salam complaining about making sujood on the ground with a naked head, naked forehead, means not covered. So we complained to him to give us an excuse. He did not give us an excuse. Shakawna lil Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam as-salah fi ar-ramda, as-salah fi ar-ramda, falam yushkina. Read it this way, فَلَمْ يُشْكِنَا. Don't say فَلَمْ يَشْكُنَا. No, فَلَمْ يُشْكِنَا means he did not accept our appeal to use our forehead, to use imama, to cover our forehead. But in reality, this hadith is not an evidence, because he did not allow them to do this because they were using a rug. Why do we need both? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam felt that they don't need this. And also another explanation, they said he did not feel that it's too hard to the extent that you keep using covers one after another. And this hadith is reported by Abu Dawood, the other hadith reported by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, and we give more credibility to the report of Bukhari and Muslim, which is hadith of Anas that he said, and we used to pray in the presence of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam and use part of our clothes. Then if there is a contradiction between We asked him and he did not allow us, and Anas, he said, we used to do it. Then which one we gave a preference? The hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. Also, do you say, there is a report that Sayyiduna Ali ibn Abi Talib, when he was doing his sujood, he was moving his imamah back. And Sayyiduna Ubadah ibn Samit also, when he did his sujood, he moved his imamah back. But this also is not a proof that it's a mandatory. They could do it, but because they would like to do it themselves. They didn't say, you have to. I can do many things in the prayer. It's not a mandatory. We do things because we like to do it. He would like to apply his forehead on the hot weather. Can he do it? Yes, he can do it. Is it a must? No, it's not a must. Two things we'll conclude with. The first one is, can we use our hand if we are praying, for example, on the rocky area or paved area, and we don't want to apply our forehead on the ground? Can we use our hand as a protection from the ground? It's not allowed according to the vast majority of scholars. Imam Abu Hanifa said it's okay, but it's against the preference. It's makruh. It's makruh. But according to the vast majority of scholars, you don't make sujood in your on the top of a part of your own body because it's not reported. And also what we say about the imamah, all of what we said about imamah, it applies on the hijab of the woman. The hijab of the woman. There also when they pray, it's the preference is to uncover their forehead. To uncover their forehead. And if they did, some women, I saw them bringing the hijab, lowering the hijab for forehead and uplifting the hijab from the chin area, just to minimize the area of the exposed area. If they are doing this and they are making their sujood on the hijab itself, part of it, then it will be according to what we said. According to the vast majority of the scholars, it's acceptable, but against the preference. Any questions? May Allah bless you all, inshallah. Continue next week.